Okay, this is another representation of it. Okay, so this is a schematic diagram of it. Remember, this is thylakoid membrane. Membrane, phospholipid bilayer. Okay, why it's called phospholipid? That thing just now, it's called phosphatidylcholine. Phosphatidylcholine. You got your head here, you got your neck here, you got your tail here. Okay, so the head here is the phosphate. In the middle here, you got your glycerol. And the tail here, you got your CH, the hydrocarbon tail, right? So that's why the membrane is called phospholipid. Phospho referring to the head, lipid referring to the glycerol. Phospholipid bilayer, two layers of it. Okay. And in between this phospholipid bilayer, there are integral protein. These are the integral protein. PS2 protein, PS1 protein, cytochrome B6F protein, and also the ATP synthase protein. Okay, you can see that they are arranged in a vectorial way, meaning that in sequence, in the right positioning. You are not going to find this PS2 protein in between cytochrome and PS1. You're not going to find it because the energy move from here to here. That's how. If the water flow from the waterfall to the river to the sea following the gravity, this thing is follow the energy transfer from the high energy to the low energy. Meaning that when you are talking about the energy content of it, this side of the membrane dealing with higher energy because they just receive it fresh from the sunlight. High energy. As you go further to this side, less amount of energy. Okay. Right. Have you seen this before? This diagram. What do you have? Stroma, the soup of it. Now, learn another thing, which is lumen. Not lumos, that's light. Lumen is the inside of the thylakoid membrane. So you got your membrane here, the inside of it. Yeah, it's kind of like your intestine, the inner of your intestine. That is the lumen where you got all your villi, your microbes, bacteria, and so on. The outside of it is the rest of it. Okay, right. So four proteins. Please do not forget that. Down the line, I know we're going to see it in a bit, but I'll just give you the pre. A heads up about the terminologies. You're going to see this thing as well. PQ, PH, PC, FD, FNR. So these things are we call as electron carrier. Okay, there's two concepts in biochemistry when it comes to molecule. A molecule can become an electron carrier or electron acceptor. If the molecule only accept electron and be done with it, for example, like this one here, an ADP plus here, it accept electron and then add hydrogen to it to become NADPH. We call NADP is an electron acceptor. Okay. However, when a compound, for example, like PQ here, which is it stands for plus 2 quinone, not only that it accepts, but it actually move and transfer the electron to somebody else. That we call electron carrier. So plus 2 quinone electron carrier, plus 2 cyanine electron carrier, but NADP electron acceptor. Okay. Look at this membrane here. Even though this image here is static because I can't find the one which is animated, this thing, these blobs of electrons carrier, they are actually moving. Okay, they move actually. about a tenth of nanometer. They move in the membrane because the membrane is fluid. They move. When they get something, they move because they need to move the electron. Okay? Because electron cannot suddenly jump. This is not, you are spearing something. It has to physically be closer to the target so that the electron can get transferred. Right? We'll see that in a bit.